Yeah, I'm a law professor who's been following the new anti-drug bill that just passed Congress, and I want to warn everyone that this looks like it might have some fairly severe implications for the national security state, particularly as regards Professor Falk's distinction between citizens and subjects. I see lots of people being forced into a very passive subject role by this. What it does is to create a $10,000 fine for any amount, any possession of any controlled substance in the preceding 5 years. This is like includes one joint. They've deliberately kept marijuana in it, not for health reasons to be sure, but because of the repressive potential. And this, as I mentioned, can simply come through the mail from the U.S. attorneys. We already have a generation of law students, half of whom are afraid to sign petitions for things they believe in. And this bill, it also has provisions effectively barring access to higher education, which will impact mainly on racial minority communities, it looks like. And I just like to alert people to this and make the plea, especially to people who either have a cultural prejudice against pot smokers, who've been conditioned by the things on TV, or are genuinely concerned about the real health problems caused by other drugs, which are real, not to jump on the bandwagon of this war against drugs, because it looks like a real chilling effect. There's one other thing. The money from this is earmarked to go into a special fund to A, pay informants, B, purchase evidence, C, purchase computerized equipment specifically for keeping track of the population in the war against drugs. And so it could be a kind of self-funding thing from a small group of fanatics, either in DEA or the Department of Justice. And it looks like it could pose real dangers if it gets going.
Well, I wonder if Dr. Singham specifically could comment on the war on drugs in juxtaposition to the comments that you made on it, and not only within the problems of the inner city, which are considerable, and as the gentleman mentioned, not only the bill on drugs, but the sweeps in LA, et cetera, the civil liberties problems, but also the foreign aspect of the war on drugs, which appears to be another vehicle for the extension of the internationalized security state, ideologically, militarily, and economically.
Very quickly, again, the fact is a number, to the foreign element first, the involvement of the political elites in the drug trade in the Third World is their guarantee for becoming and remaining members of the police state, for the control of their own population. So that the main activity of the state in much of the Third World and some parts of the reactionary Latin America is violence, which we will discuss later on this afternoon in our panel.
Wonderful. How many more questions? Well,
okay, my question doesn't have so much to do with what's going on right now in the United States, but what was going on in the Third World after World War II. As I'm sure most of the panelists know, the main U.S. development policy in World War II, particularly in Asia, was the doctrine of modernization, which was particularly important after the Chinese Revolution. And my own research has indicated that the doctrine of modernization, especially urbanization, was essentially an anti-communist doctrine. And I found some support for this by a man whom I hesitate to quote, but I will nonetheless, Samuel Huntington, who quotes during the Vietnam War, yes, here at Harvard, stated that Mao's rural revolution is undercut by the US-backed urban revolution. And so my question is, when I present this to students in classes, sometimes they look at you like you're a little bit crazy. They look at you like you're a conspiracy thinker. And then you talk to some other people, some development people that I've tried my theory on, and they look at you and they say, well, maybe that was going on, but there were other things going on too. The US was essentially trying to export a liberal economic model that worked in the United States. So my question is, one, do you think this is a correct analysis of the modernization doctrine? And two, how do you respond to these people who say that it was really just the United States trying to help out the economies of the third world countries? Thank
you. I want to take a few questions to finish, because people have been waiting a long time, and then we'll answer what we can at the end, all right? But let's have all the questions.
I think maybe mine's a follow-up on this lady's question, but it's directed to Professor Falk. And I think that what underlies all the presentations here and what we've been talking about is that we are protecting the citadel is inequality. This is what we're protecting. And that is immoral. And I think until we are prepared to deal with that,